Today we are here to celebrate Krishna Puja. I went to America and they wanted me to have a Mahakali Puja. But I said, no, let me talk about Krishna only. Because we have to first realize what is the strength of this puja. How are we going to establish Sri Krishna within ourselves? He himself has said that whenever there is a downfall of dharma, dharma doesn't mean what we understand as Hinduism, Christianity or Islamic nonsense. It is not. Dharma means our primordial taboos that are built in the human beings. About these, I think Aboriginals knew better than we. But then, what we did, we dominated them, and also they had to change their style of life. The primordial taboos are only understood if people are trying to understand oneself, or else whatever has come to them through tradition. Now, Sahaj Dharma is little bit different in the sense that is much higher than the Sahaj ideas that we talk of, but is much higher than even what Sri Krishna said or Sri Rama said. First, Sri Rama thought best is to give them disciplines. People should be serious about life, have full idea about their own being, they should respect themselves. All these things were written down long time back. Also, people, basically when they were good people, they understood that whatever is bad for us, we should not. These are primordial taboos. Now, these primordial taboos are built in within us. Now, supposing I say, don't drink, you will go and drink. If I say, don't tell lies, you will tell lies. It's the human nature. You see, it's to go against primordial taboo because they think now they have freedom. Freedom to do what they like. You are free people. Actually, they are not. They are under the spell of all the kinds of allurement, you can call it, or temptations which are against human life. And it's very natural to be a person of dharma. Small children mostly have it. For example, I've seen children, they feel very shy to take out their clothes. Even small boys I've seen, they won't take out their clothes in the presence of others. They feel shy. So all these are described like Ya Devi Sarvabhuteshu Lajja Rupena Sansita. So you should be shy. You should be humble. And respect your body. It's very important in these modern times. Exposure of body is regarded as a great achievement of women. They are trying to become aboriginals, you see. That time they never had these ideas. And they were not so confused, you see. So even if the woman was scantily dressed, it didn't mean that it was some sort of a sex or some sort of a attraction for men, or men behaving in funny manners to show that they have a special attraction for women. I mean, why should you? It is absolutely absurd. that men should be attracted to women and women should be attracted to men. And on the road, on the street, you go, you see just that going on. This adharma is the worst, I think, for it's a curse. Because after coming to Sahayoga also people start doing this nonsense, you know. They should all go to lunatic asylum, I think. They're no good for Sahayoga. But dharma get established as soon as you have the light of the spirit. At the time of Sri Rama, he had to put down A, B, C, D, E, F. At the time of Moses also, he had to put down 10 commandments. But Krishna thought the other way around. To establish a dharma of pure love, pure love. So, because he wanted that Sri Rama's taboos were forced on people. Just like Islamic, just like Christians, never works. So he thought better to ask them in their freedom, they must develop pure love. Radha, who was with him as his power, is called as Alladayini. She's the one who gives joy, pure joy. So all these limited type of attractions end up in trouble. Now drinking is against, you know that. Today they are talking about tobacco, tomorrow they'll talk of drinking when they will find so many people suffering from horrible livers and dying. Then they will taboo it. But it's a natural taboo for your body. If you do something all the time which is not good for your good life, you are becoming adharma. This is to be understood very clearly, that the sahaja dharma is that you are just free, complete freedom from lust, greed, and all nonsense. You are above it. You are above the search. Dharma is above the dharma established by Sri Krishna or by Sri Rama. Because you have reached that stage, is in complete freedom, you have to be dharma. Whatever is not good for you, you should not do. I don't have to tell you that you don't do this or you don't do that. Whatever I say may not be acceptable, but immediately your vibrations will tell. This is Sahaja Dharma. In the Sahaja Dharma, you get rid of all kinds of, as they say, kama, krodha, mada, matsara, lobha, moha, means lust, anger, attractions, then havrat panala ka mantat English?
Greed.
Greed, greed, ha, greed. That's very important. Greed, greed. And attractions. Now, if you understand how people are greedy, greedy for what? This America is dying of consumerism, you see. Now see the trick of the trade. In America, you can borrow any amount of money from the bank, no problem. Now, even if you don't borrow, they'll send you a letter. Why don't you take 20,000 check we are sending you, why not have it? Ah, very rich you become, you see. I say very nice to take the loan. I was told some people used to come to Ganpatipule after taking loans. I said, stop that nonsense. So they take the loan and then they come to Ganpatipule. All the time their mind is, how will I pay this loan? How will I manage? All the time the attention is distracted. Even when you want to do something good to yourself of coming to Ganpatipuri. So such a mind is not free. The free mind is that which has attention completely enlightened by the Spirit. But problem is, we are still rising out of this human bondage to a higher life of realization. And when we are going to that level, we have to realize that we have to give up all these shackles, all these horrible things within us. Like a bird, when it is born, out of the egg sheds out all the parts of the egg. Your brothers, your sisters, your father, your mother, your husband, everybody. They try to put you down. Now if they are drinking, they'll say, come along. You better have something to drink. You are not social. You are useless. You are not up to date. What is this nonsense? That's how a fashion starts. And this collective action of fashion didn't come from Sri Krishna. And not in Sahaj. In Sahaj, you are absolutely free from all these nonsenses. If you want, you can wear good dress. If you don't want, you need not. You are free. You are free from money bondage. This is very important. Money bondage is another thing. I know some Sahaj Yogis who came to Sahaj Yoga trying to make money out of Sahaj Yoga. Oh, yeah. You came to Sahaj Yoga for what? To get out of that money bondage. In the Sahaj Dharma, to you money is nothing but dust of your feet. Nothing so important. Then we have such a collective sense of accepting nonsense. That has to be dropped off. Especially in America, I was surprised. Also in England, a fellow came as a hippie. His hair were looking like some monkey. Monkey is better, I must say. I don't know like what. All put together like a, you can say, I mean, there's nothing to compare, I tell you. So, I asked him, why are you having such hair? He said, because I want to be primitive. Now we have to get to the primitiveness. I said, but your brain is modern. What's the use of growing hair like that? You think you can become primitive? You cannot. Then afterwards I learned that he died. Another one like that came and he didn't die but went to lunatic asylum. Like that I met many. But why do you do it? Because that's the fashion. Now Italy, you know, is prospering because of all kinds of designers. Now there's a joke about the noirish people in Russia especially. Russians are not like that. Normally, they don't accept something because it's a fashion. So one fellow said that, my God, you lost your hand in the accident. Doesn't matter. But I lost my very expensive watch from Switzerland. Really? What? It was Rolex. Doesn't matter if the hand is gone. The Rolex gone? Rolex is the fashion. Can you remove him, dog? This one, because people can't see you. So, these are noirish people who have money. It's all right, now he'll be able. Come now. Sit down, sit down. Now go down. They don't form any fashions. I have not seen dogs taken to any fashions. Monkeys taking, I mean, supposing you see the Italian designers make something special for them, they won't think much of it. Maybe their masters might buy, but not these animals. Now, we don't have to become animals, of course, but we don't also have to become slaves of fashions. So there are some shops which are very expensive. Why? Because they are designers. So you move about telling everybody, see, I'm wearing this thing from a designer shop, this is from designer shop. That means, what about you? You have no sense of designs. You have no sense of understanding what you need and what you don't need. And nowadays most of them are in jail also, sorry to say, but they have money. And they have made money by befooling them. Especially in America, I was surprised that they were selling most of the things which were coming from Italy, designs, Italian design, written them Italian design, so they were buying it, Italian design. I was surprised that such artistic things they create that are available everywhere, such beautiful things. But what they believe in is some sort of a group madness. Everybody wearing the same kind of designs from this or that. This is not Sajdharma. We are not slaves of anything. We are free people. We are not to accept any design or anything. Ah, it is there, it's there. Let the stupid follow that. We are Sajogis. Now this also prevails among people who are supposed to be sadhus. They all dress up the same way. How can you make out who is who? In Sahaja, we don't want you to dress up the same way, look the same way, cut your hair the same way. No. You have to be individuals because you are free. But that doesn't mean freedom is always supported by wisdom. That doesn't mean that you do what you like. All kinds of funny things happen when person doesn't know what is the light of the Spirit. In the light of the Spirit, you don't get involved into this kind of collective madness that is going on. We are so collective in mad things, I wish they could be collective more in wise things. Wisdom is very important. And a joy-giving quality of Radhaji, Allah Dadaini Shakti, has to come within us. Means when we meet another person in the collectivity, another person should feel happy meeting. So he taught the dharma of love. Love is not there if you discard because he's black or because he's brown, because he's white. He's very superficial. What is black, white and yellow, I don't understand. Here they go to the seashores to make themselves black. And there they say, we don't want to have any blacks, especially for Americans. I think this kind of separation I found there among the blacks and the white, I really wept. I went to Harlem. Sahajyogi said, Mother, will you go to Harlem? I said, why not? I am black. If you call me black, I am black. If you call me white, I am white. If you call me yellow, I am yellow. So I'm going. And there I had a lecture. You know, so many people were there, really. I cannot forget. It is one of the most famous place that there is built in that hall. And the same hall is built in Australia, where I had addressed many people. I thought, just look at this. They said, Mother, the Australians copied from us. Now, these people, so sweet, so beautiful, I tell you. I could see their heart. I could feel it. And the fellow was trying to compare. After my lecture, he just came, he hugged me, kissed me. I mean, he would have even minced me. Little boy, about 22 years of age. Such love he felt. And he said, Mother, next time you come, you are going to come to Harlem. But I am told that hall is closed. So the American system, somehow or other, goes against democracy. Not only against democracy, but against what Abraham Lincoln wanted. He had, they had such a great man there. And there's a little street I saw in his name. Of course, in Washington they say they have some nice, beautiful statue. But otherwise, his principles are finished. His ideals are finished. Because somehow or other, some people came and wrote against him, from England especially, against the black people. What business they have to write against something that is created by God? If there are the same colors everywhere, they all will look like military people. They have to have different colors. They have to have different hues. See, look at the trees, look at the flowers, and look at the different hues the sky has, just to make us happy, Allah. What gives you happiness is variety. Variety is a sign of beauty. If there is no variety, it's so boring, I tell you, so very boring. But they are very proud of it, and they think no end of themselves. They think they are very great people. They have a sense of superiority because they have a certain type of nose, or maybe certain type of lips, or maybe certain types of hair. Such stupid things they are. And you join hands with them. How can you join hands with them? You want your freedom? Then be a free person. In the freedom, you have to have variety. Very important. I would say that now the Sahyogis who are going back to America should have a new style of drive. Go to the black people. I was very happy to see the South American seminar that they had taken special to Aboriginal people. They went and met them. I have met them also. And I was so surprised that they immediately said, Mother, you are spiritual, we know. But can you solve our problem? I said, what is your problem? Very simple, we have a land. All right, then, very little land, 5-6 acres of land, that belongs to us, where the sage grows. Sage is a kind of a, according to them, is a holy plant. All right. Now, we always meet, all of us, there for different festivals, because we regard that land as a holy land. They know so many things, you know. This is the holy land. There were vibrations for that. So they always used to meet. So natural. So what has happened now? What is your problem? The government has sold this land, this American government, to an Indian. I said, to an Indian? Yes. So can you request this Indian to return it to us? We'll pay him the money. I said, what's the name of the Indian? They told me the name. I said, my God, he's a Sindhi. Sindhi, he won't leave even one single pie. Is he going to give you this? I'm sorry, I may be divine, or I may be anything, I can't. But I was surprised nobody raised a voice against it. They should have raised voice. They should have told the government, please return their land. Why do you want to have it? Why want to grab it? As it is, all the Americans are immigrants. They don't belong to that place. That they were not owners of that place. That gone, they are immigrants. So they have no right to keep somebody's land like that and then to think they are superior. It's very nice. Somebody enters your house and thinks he's very superior and drives out all the people of the family. That is what has happened in America. And just the opposite is Sahaja Dharma. With Sahaja Dharma, you take people into your heart. You love them. Your love flows all the time. Your compassion flows all the time. To me, it's a problem. This body is more compassionate than myself. I don't even think of compassion, and this body just grasps everything. It wants to solve the problem of others. But I don't think you can have that kind of a body, you shouldn't have, but at least you should have a heart which is open. You see on the street somebody who is a dark fellow. I liked about black Americans that once I got down in one airport, so one gentleman, black gentleman, "Hello, darling, how are you? How are you here? Very happy to see." I said, "I'm happy to see you. How are you?" Then once I was traveling Ursula was with me. So he looked at me, one fellow, very tall, hefty, fat, you know. He said, "Ah, are you back again?" "Huh?" I said, "I'm back. You know me?" Of course, I know you." He had never met me, I've never known. But I felt happy. I felt very happy. That's the best way to meet people. Supposing you are walking on the street. You see some black gentleman going. It's a terrible life there. I tell you, it's a terrible life for them. I've known, I've read books on them, and I've cried and wept, and I've felt very sorry. So, as a Sahaja Yogi, you should just jump at them. And you should say, "Hello, how are you?" Shake hands with them. They won't cut your throat, I can tell you. In criminality, I don't know who is more criminal in America, whether they are the blacks or the whites, competing. But if you are kind and if you are loving, you can remove that part of criminality which is within them, because hatred can be only washed away by pure love. But people think they are very cunning, very superior in cunningness, of course. Otherwise, what is their superiority? Only this complexion, this white complexion is the worst of all. I was very fair till I got married or for some time. Then I started becoming darker and darker. Because white complexion gets all kinds of, the light you put on me absorbs. I get a black spot. So, not a very great thing to be white. I don't think so. It looks very funny and pale and joyless. But no use going to the sea, making your body, brown there, not so black, brown. And then suffering from cancer of the skin. This kind of stupidity is also very much fashionable. Now, in collectivity, how much do we get impressed by these? We should be on the watch. I saw my granddaughter was wearing a sleeveless dress. I told her, "Bitte, you shouldn't wear a sleeveless dress." She says, "Very hot, I feel very hot." She's young. I said, "But see, these are two very important chakras. If you expose them, then you'll have a problem." She doesn't like to wear dresses which are above the knee. But she says, "People wear even above the knee." I said, "Knee, they are very important chakras. We should keep them closed. Otherwise, if they are affected, we'll have knee trouble." Immediately she changed. Immediately, "Mother, I'll wear blouse from inside and something from outside." Immediately. Because she knew this is a natural, primordial taboo that we should not expose ours. These two chakras and these chakras. But nowadays, the more you have long legs, I don't know. They have shorter clothes. I don't understand what is in the legs. The whole beauty is in the legs or what? So, I met one lady who traveled with me. She was wearing a burqa because she was a Muslim. And by the time we landed in London, she took out the burqa and the dress was much above the knees. I said, what kind of Muslim woman is she? She is worse than even Christians because they won't wear such a thing, you know, to come out of the aeroplane. You have to come down on the staircase. No lajja, no shame, nothing. Shamelessness. So, sahaj dharma is that you have shame. You have sense of shame. What you talk to others, what you say to others, how you behave towards them in the sahaj dharma is Allah Daini. If something is not Allah Daini, keep quiet. Don't say. What is the need? What is there to be sarcastic, showing off your brains in your sarcasm? It's not a sign of good breeding that you talk sarcastically to others in a sharp way. But if you talk sweetly, what's the harm? This sweetness comes from Radhaji. Now, of course, they have misused her and made her into a sort of a Romeo-Juliet business. It was not that. She was a very pure woman and she was Mahalakshmi. So to be a Mahalakshmi, after coming to Sahaja Yoga, you should know that you should dress up in a way that's perfectly all right. Once I remember I was in a big party and one gentleman came. And he said, ha. I said, what happened? What a relief, Mother, Mrs. Srivastava, to see you. See these women. I'm fed up. But you came, I felt such a relief. I said, what is so relief? You are so serene. So women are serene in Sahaja Dharma. They're not stupid, frivolous, laughing at anything. That's not the way for a woman. Anything happens, they must laugh. I mean, there's something laughable or all right, but some things are not even laughable, they'll laugh. That's not the way. That can be ridiculous also, can ridicule others. But laugh of appreciation, laugh of enjoyment is so pure and creates such beautiful atmosphere. I think the whole ecological problem is in our brains and your upbringing. It is not outside. It is inside us, which is reflected outside. In Ganesha Puja, I am going to tell you how we are so closely related to Mother Earth and how the Mother Earth and the atmosphere reacts to our behavior, to how we live. In the Sahaja Dharma, you give up lust and greed very easily, that I know. I mean, if they can't even give up that, then they should not call themselves Sahaja. The first thing you give up is lust and greed. I find it among young people now that those who come to Sahaja Yoga become really very free people. They don't run after women. Women don't run after men. They are together, they sit together, talk together, laugh together. But it is purity that is. In the Quran is described that when Qiyama will come, beautiful women and beautiful men will be there. But they'll have no lust and greed, they'll be pure. Yes, today you can see that lust and greed is finished. Most of you, automatically it is finished, and now you can see for yourself that you are free of this bondage. Then our marriages are coming tomorrow. In the Sahaja Dharma, first thing is very important is forgiveness. If somebody cannot forgive, then he cannot be a Sahajyogi. Forgiveness. How this forgiveness comes in is by forgetting the past. Otherwise you will go on saying, this person tortured me, that person tortured me, he was very mean to me, he was that to me, he did this to me. Shows that you are not of that caliber to understand Sahajyoga. Because you cannot forgive. What is there to remember? The present is the best. Now if you are sitting here with me, enjoying the Allah, the Daini Shakti, that time if you are thinking about the past, shows what? That you are not of the caliber. To be the caliber of Sahajyoga, you should be free of your past. Finished. There's no need to confess. I know after Sahajyoga, many people wrote letters to me of confessions. And I just said, Baba, just burn these letters. I don't remember. I don't want to read anything about anyone. So there should be forgiveness. If there is forgiveness, you will be surprised. You will feel very relieved and your married life will be very happy. But if you try to remember something, alright, some marriages are really, really very difficult, alright? So you get out. In Sahaja Yoga we have allowed complete divorce, but must be with some reason. Not because you think something is superior. Now we have banned many countries from where we don't want to have girls, or from where we don't want to have boys. What is the reason? With experience we have learned, they are not marriage substance. Now, then better not marry. And if you marry, then live like an ideal Sahajyogi. Also, if you are a Sahajyogini, then you can carry on very much better by forgiving all the time. Every time when people tell me, my mother, you see, you must help me. Why? Because, you know, my husband doesn't give me any money. I said, give him up. I don't mind. He must give you money. Why doesn't he give you money? If you talk to the husband, he'll say, mother, she's very extravagant. I said, you better give up Sahajyoga, both of you, and do what you like. In Sahaja Dharma, the husband-wife's relation should be really romantic, should be really beautiful. It is not, you know, we talk of love and all that here. Very rarely people fall in love and carry on with it. It's a blessing if you really get that kind of a feeling. But mostly it is a curse. So to fall in love is very good. But that doesn't mean you forget that you are Sahajyogi. In that, Sahajyoga helps a lot, I think, in your married life. Same dharma is for your children, that you bring up your children, not troubling them too much, but into a free life. Let them use their wisdom. Sometimes I know children go astray and try to follow wrong things. Then you must correct them. You must tell them, it's your duty. They were not born out of the trees, but they were born here, from the parents. So it's the duty of the parents to tell them that this is wrong and this should not be done. It's a very wrong thing. You should correct that. And that correction should be in a Sahaja way. I'll tell you an example. I had a problem once with somebody coming to me than saying, "Mother, I can't do without smoking, I have to smoke." I said, "Better smoke then." "But you can't be a Sahajyogi, because smoking Sahajyogi is a funny caricature, you know. I can't think of a Sahajyogi smoking. How will I look if I start smoking like that?" "Ah, horrible." I said, "Then, if you are my son, you cannot smoke, it looks bad." I gave up smoking, can you imagine? So dealing with children, always make yourself an example, yourself part and parcel of that advice, so the children don't feel, you know. This is something that I have talked many a times. Children is one thing, I tell you. They can give up everything, but not your love. If they know you love them, they will not accept anything that will make you not love them. This is for definite, because children are the best people who know about love. Of course, I don't know, I feel that in English language I didn't see many books about children, written beautiful, beautiful things. There was one book that was published when I was in London, the children talking about the politicians. And they published, I think, 5,000 books, and that very same day it was finished. So talk to children. Talk to them, you'll be amazed. They are full of honey. They have such nice things with them. And when they talk like that, then you are amazed. How they say things, how they talk of Sahaj, how they are expressing their spiritual strength. Now, we have many very good children. And also, they are absolutely Sahaj. One boy came and he just prostrated himself before me. So I said, "Why you did it?" "No, I was getting cool vibrations, mother, from you. So I did it." "Is it, you like it?" "Of course. More than chocolate? Of course." I was surprised. "What, you eat them or what?" "No need to eat, you know. You feel so happy inside. And I feel, mother, you are putting your hand on my heart and trying to console me." Surprised, I said, "Where is your heart?" He says, here is my heart. I feel it here." And just imagine what love and what understanding of Sahaja for these little children who are below even 5 years. Now you are all grown-up children of mine. And I want you to know all the beauties that are within you that you have to enjoy. First of all, learn to laugh at yourself. That's the best way to enjoy yourself, you know. And not to spend much time on the mirror, in the mirror. That's another way. If you spend too much time on the mirror, then something wrong with you. Not, I think personally that it is kind of a possession maybe. So what you should see inside? Are we Sahaj Dharmis? Mother has established Sahaj Dharma. Much more than what Krishna wanted to establish. He wanted to establish the dharma of love, which of course we have. But apart from that, we have so many other beautiful facets and such beautiful things within our personality that we have forgotten to enjoy. So the attention should be on your own qualities, on your own personalities. And then you will be amazed how your personality is giving you joy, giving you Allah, giving you so much of patience with others. To me, the whole thing looks like sometimes a joke, because nothing so serious. It's not Rama's type. that you have to be serious. I don't have to kill anybody. I don't use any weapons in this lifetime. Without weapons, if things are solved, what can you do? But you must try to see the beauty as Sahaj Yogis. You should be sensitive to see how you have been helped, how you have been guided, how you have been blessed. This is Sahaj Dharma. If you cannot know that, then you live on a very low level. I mean, it's not fault of Sahaj Yoga, but it's your style. You are not sensitive. For supposing somebody is not, does not burn his hand. So what will you do? He has no sense, he has no sensitivity. He cannot feel. He can drink, he can smoke, he can do everything, and still he's existing all right. Must be a Rakshasa, I think, or I don't know what to say. So we have to take example from other good Sahaj Yogis and not from the bad ones. And how do we proceed in enjoyment, which is an ocean, just an ocean. For example, now I came, everybody was trying to fan. But also in the West, another problem is they like to live in hermetically sealed rooms, hermetically sealed cars. They are very afraid of draft. I don't know, as if they'll be thrown away or what will happen to them. They don't want draft. I mean, it's not, draft is not coming from some iceberg. So they don't believe in the fresh air at all. And that's another reason that people are very suffocating sometimes, you know. They just suffocate. They are used to suffocating life. Once I was in India, it was very hot. So somebody was driving me, but the person who was there was from Western countries. He said, don't open the window. I said, why? There's draft. I said, in this country, in India, people live in the open. What is a draft? What draft you are talking about? You can't open the door, you can't open the window, you can't open anything. If you open anything, they'll be all dead, you see, as if. So open yourself. As it is about the nature, also it is in their private lives. They don't want to open. If somebody comes to their eyes, oh my God, now we'll have to share the wines, we'll have to share the foods. They cannot share. They cannot share. That is most uncollective. But in India, I must say, people have a good sharing capacity because they are still primitive. They are still primordial, yet not gone out of the way to satisfy their own ego. But I think somehow or other in India, people like to share. If you want to please any Indian, you tell them, tomorrow I'll come and have food with you. His wife will jump. She'll say, now what do you like? Tell me, what food you like? She'll jump. But otherwise, what happens? As soon as you say he's coming for food, the wife will say, no, no, I am going to my mother. Immediately she'll have a program. I just don't understand. They'll have beautiful houses, very clean, very beautiful, everything. But if somebody comes to their house, they get a shock, as if electricity has entered. So for whom is all this? To show off, they will borrow money from the banks. Even Indians and America, they do. They want to have 3 Mercedes, 4 houses, for what? Borrowing money. With the borrowing money, they'll do it. Sahaj Yogis have not to borrow any money. There's no need. You can do away with things. Why to have so many cars? Nowadays people don't even walk at all. We used to go to our school, my father had a car in India. Nothing doing. We had to walk. We used to climb one mountain. It was about 5 miles, the school. Every morning, then in the night, in the evening, the car used to come. And I would walk with my bare feet because so much vibrations and on the chappals I thought were cutting my vibrations. So I used to have chappals in my hand and walk. One day we had a new driver. My father sent him. He said, how will I know who is the daughter? He said, any girl with chappals in her hand is the one whom you have to bring. So, it is to enjoy your nobility, to enjoy your generosity. It's very important. And not to side with anyone. You're not identified with anyone. It's much better now, I think, because since you have taken to search Dharma, I have seen English will tell you what's wrong with English, Swiss will tell you what's wrong with Swiss, Indians will tell you what's wrong with Indians. Actually, I learned from them. I don't know these things are there. Russians will tell you what's wrong with Russians. They immediately start seeing what's wrong with us. Where do we lack in this? Because the collectivity of being in one country, southern India, we see now what's happening in India. All corrupt, horrible, this, that. So I said, all right, if you don't like India, why don't you go somewhere else? No, that will stay here. But this is a very corrupt government, they're very bad, this, that. Anywhere you go, you will find immediately they see. Because you don't know, they are now chosen to change their country. I have taken up many questions now of India and I am going to start working on that level. We have already started in a way for the destitute women, then for other type of poverty and all that. Just by saying remove poverty, poverty cannot be lost. You have to have feeling for the poor. Then only, but you get it more that feeling because you are an Indian. You are an Indian, so what? Your own brother, sister starving. You get that very deep feeling within you if you are a Sahaj Dharmi. So this is the new dharma we have established now. In this world, a new race with a new dharma, which is much above even Sri Krishna's vision is coming true. He describes in the beginning, I think he was not a good salesman because he describes the best first. You see, the salesman first will start from 2 rupees, then go onward to 2,000. But he first told us that you have to become sthitapragya, means search yogi. And then Sri Krishna was asked a question by Arjuna, what is the sthitapragya? Then he describes the search yogi. That he described before. First, second chapter is that. Now, then the questions start. You know, Arjuna was a great questioner, I think. So he starts asking questions, then what about this, and what about that, and what about that. So he goes on explaining to him that, you see, this is all just a maya. This is all an illusion you are. Get out of this illusion. If once you get out of this illusion, because Arjuna said, they are my relations, they are my teachers, how can I kill you? So Krishna said, nobody is killed. He said, nobody is killed, but they are being killed because they are not following the Satya Dharma. So it's all right. What is your brother? What is your sister? They are not following the Satya Dharma. So you have nothing to do with them. If you can correct them and help them, it's all right. Otherwise, forget them. First, deal with people who are straight. Like we should say that we must deal with people who are simple, innocent. And then you can take to difficult people when you are that good. Otherwise you will come here saying, Mother, I have caught this, I have caught that. So in Sahaja Dharma, you being the spirit, you also know about others very well. And you can make it out who is who, what chakras they are catching. But the trouble in America, I found that Sahaja Yogis used to just would go and tell somebody, you are catching on this chakra. Now he's come for the first time and you tell him, you are very egoistical. He said, how do you know? Your agya is catching. Maybe his own agya might be catching. Is this the way to receive a new person? Is this the way to talk to a new person? See, on the contrary, he should say, come, sit down. Very nice, you are very great. See, because they are still ignorant, so they like some sort of a buttering, as you call it, you see. We call it chaplusi. Then gradually, because you are doing this just to make him a Sahaja Yogi. Because you love him. Basically, that is the reason. But as soon as somebody comes in, if you tell him, this is wrong with you, that's wrong with you. This is not a Pope's business, where you go on telling people what's wrong with them, go and confess. To whom? To all these silly people. It's not that. What we have to show that you have fallen in love with that person. You are nice to that person because you like that person. Then gradually you fill him up. But as soon as he comes, you give him one shot. So finished. How can you have good relations? Americans have to learn this. I don't know why Americans think they are very superior people. I tell you, for wisdom, I would not say they are so good. It's completely lacking wisdom in them. And they misunderstand people very fast. Start judging others is not the way you can have Sahaja Dharma. Sahaja Dharma is you are your own. You are in your own. You are in your own realm and in your happiness and joy. Where is the time to criticize others? So the best thing is to show your maximum love to everyone. In that love, you should not show your pity, but love which is again Allahadaya. This is the message of Shri Krishna, but I don't know how many understood it. Now what you find, those who are following Shri Krishna like Radhe, Hare Rama people, they are actually beggars on the street. He is Kubera and his disciples are all beggars. Can you imagine? Does he add to his glory as a Kubera? So, Sahaja Yogis are not like that. Should be generous. Should not bother too much about yourself. Should not all the time think about yourself. But think of the collectivity, how you be. Collectivity is not to bring, force people to come to Sahaja. Once they come to Sahaja, they will know the joy of life. And you don't have to tell them anything. Nothing has to be told. Just silently it will work and they will feel your love. You see, love is something so great. It not only helps others, but also helps you. It's so joyous to give realizations to others. But if you start telling, your this chakra is catching, then why are you giving realization? If you don't know how to give realization, better not do it. So to criticize is not the way we can enjoy love. Of course you can pull legs of each other sometimes, just for fun's sake. But not to harm, not to torture, not to make that person fall. You are all Sahaja Dharmis, you have accepted Sahaja Dharma, and in Sahaja Dharma, we have to have pure love of the heart, not hypocrisy. And sensible life. Now this Pope is against abortion, I am not. If a woman is suffering, let her have abortion. The one who is living is more important than who are not living. If somebody wants to have abortion, that child can be born again. According to us, nobody dies permanently. Whatever it may be, so this is one way they use it for propagation of human beings. Like they say, the Muslim women are like a factory. They go on producing more children, more children, more children. So there are more voters. So the Pope knows that. See, that's why he said abortion, no. Christians should not abort, because then there will be less Christians to compete with the Muslims. But in Sahaja Yoga, we don't have such funny, radical, nonsensical things. We have divorce and we have also abortion, which is important to understand that these are all taboos which are there, but not for people who have to get out of the troubles. You have to help. And that's how it works. But to be very frank, we don't have to do abortions. It is achieved by Param Chaitanya. Param Chaitanya does for me. I don't have to. I don't have to do anything. It's Param Chaitanya. It's nice because it knows what is to be done, how to achieve. And sometimes you are in trouble, then know that you are not leaving things into the hands of the Param Chaitanya. If you leave into the hands of Param Chaitanya, things will work out very well. So to understand Sahaja Yoga, first and foremost thing is how much you are enjoying yourself. How much enjoyment you are giving to others. For that you have music, you have this, that. I was saying that today I won't speak much, but somehow, Shri Krishna, you can't keep quiet. He played murli, basuri, flute. Look at him. I talked to you, but he just played murli. He didn't talk so much, except for a Gita. You won't find him talking. And those who read also Gita are horrible people, actually, I've met. Those who read Gita, they don't understand what is Shri Krishna's dharma is. If they don't understand Shri Krishna, how will they understand Sahaja? So if for all of you is to practice on love, on forgiveness, on appreciating others, on giving joy to others. Some of the Sahaja Yogis have been very kind to me. Once I went to the shop to buy a sari for myself. And the sari was very expensive for my purpose. So I didn't buy. I said, let it be. This color suits me all right, but doesn't matter. I didn't have so much money to buy. So that Sahaja Yogi bought that sari. And on my birthday, gave me a really. I could not see it because my eyes were filled with tears. Just a small thing like that. Normally I don't expect you to do anything for me, no. But small, small things make you so happy. But even if you do this to somebody, may not understand, may not realize, may not feel it. But if you are a Sahaja Yogi, you will. So thank you very much for all this that I have said to you. Try to enjoy yourself and make others enjoy you. May God bless you.